Hello, hello, and welcome back. I guess there's more to this case, and I need to know, because I don't understand. I don't want to interrupt your relaxing time, but you haven't finished this case. The man committed suicide by hanging with the doorknob. If so, why was the man found dead? Why was he dead in the middle of the room? Oh, I got it. Someone made it look like a murder. Why didn't I realize it? So the criminal who killed the victim was the victim himself, but there was a real criminal who made it look like a murderer. I completely forgot about that. Who was the real criminal who made the man's suicide look like a murder case and assaulted the secretary? Sumiko, are you alright? Yes, I'm alright. The man took his life himself, so the alibis of the suspects aren't valid. Huh. Let's follow what Sose told me. I simulated if each suspect is criminal one by one. When you hit the wall and there's no way out, think of the other hypothesis. Imagining if another suspect is the criminal. Think about it calmly. I can get to the truth. By considering the motive and alibis, I can identify it. The motive and alibis? I can guess the motive only with the information described in this hint card. And the man took his life. This means the established estimated time of death and actual criminal time aren't the same. By these facts, a person who doesn't have an alibi is the criminal. Who is that? The criminal is the secretary? Because the secretary is the one that found him dead? No, because that just puts us into more of a loophole that the secretary assaulted herself. I want to say the secretary, or the son, I'm not sure. The secretary is the criminal. Hmm? What is the reason? The secretary was working on his own. He doesn't have his alibi. So the secretary hit his head with the pot and made it look like someone attacked him. Why did the secretary make the man's suicide look like a murder case? What? What is the advantage of making it look like murder? I know. At least I couldn't guess the advantage of murdering the man just with the information described in the hint card. The person who can profit by making the man's suicide look like a murder is a criminal. The son? Because he had like an airtight alibi. For the wife. The criminal is the victim's wife. Yes, yes! Whatever the estimated time of death or the actual criminal time was, the son had an alibi because he was chatting with his friend and playing an online game. And the secretary doesn't have an alibi. However, what is the merit for the secretary to make it look like killing the man? It's the process of elimination. I nodded. I totally did that before failing once. The estimated time of death was at 8 p.m. At that time, his wife was in a taxi. The man took his life himself, so the criminal hid the man's suicide after 20 p.m. Good translations. That's right. So his wife doesn't have an alibi. Furthermore, she's part of his family. She had the advantage of making his suicide look like murder. What is the advantage for her to make the man's suicide look like a murder? Inheritance? Insurance money? It's the insurance, I guess. The insurance doesn't cover for suicide. I think so too. Otoko nodded. I have no evidence, but this is the only possible motive that I can think of, with the limited information of the wife, the son, and the secretary. Well done. I came to the insurance idea when I was making this mystery. Oh, do you mean Thaimon took a piece of paper out of her pocket and gave it to me. Here's the barbecue ticket. Kotoko and I looked at each other. He looks like a happy puppy. Good job, Tsumugu. The wife came home by taxi. She found that her husband hung himself from the doorknob. The wife wanted to get the insurance money. She moved her husband from the door to make it look like murder. By chance, the secretary came into the room. The wife hit the head of the secretary with the pot from behind to make it look like a criminal case. That's it. Is there anyone else who identified the criminal apart from us? You're the fifth group who made it. Fifth group? Oh, I thought that we were the first. But I liked your detective show a lot. It's better to carry out reasoning in front of an audience. It looks more like a mystery. Daimon gave another piece of paper to us with a big smile. Please write down your signature on this certificate of entering the mystery club. No, we didn't mean to join the mystery club.
What?
Kotoko said softly, yet clearly. The same as Kotoko. I didn't think of joining the mystery club. We did it for the barbecue ticket.
I see. What a pity.
I thought that you would be able to be active members with your reasoning skills in the mystery club. But I won't force you. Daimon sadly shook her head. I feel a bit of regret when I refused her offer. So, we're leaving. Alright. Thank you very much. Kotoko bowed to Daimon and left the room. I bowed to Daimon after Kotoko. Tsumugu.
Yes?
You don't have to join the club. But come and visit me sometimes whenever you want.
Yes. Thank you.
Daimon smiled at me.
Why is that? Does she like me?
No way. Although I've never had a romantic experience, I know that Daimon didn't mean it. But I felt there was a reason in her words.
But what reason?
Maybe having a date. That's a good title of a chapter. After we left the mystery club, Kotoko happily stared at the barbecue ticket.
Yes, let's go to the barbecue restaurant.
Yes. Having a barbecue with a girl. Can I say that we're going to have a date?
Yeah, I can. This is a date.
When are we going to go?
I'm free tonight.
I'm fine too, but you should ask Sosei first.
Sosei? Why Sosei?
What? Are you going to use the barbecue ticket for just the two of us?
Why not?
Because Sosei helped us find the answer the most. She was right. Without Sosei's clue, we would never have been able to find out who the criminal. But this is my chance to go on a date with Kotoko.
But...
You're right. Let's not make him an outcast. Getting what I want just for myself sounds very nasty.
Good. I feel bad if we don't invite him.
Kotoko smiled. Back in time at high school, Kotoko was a leader in a girls group. Her girls group wasn't nasty. She was the leader of a group of nice girls. I think she doesn't like to treat someone as an outcast.
I'll ask Sosei later.
Good. See you then.
Oh, Tsumugu, you try so hard.
I'm home. Was it the wife?
When I stepped into the living room, Sosei said this, watching TV on the sofa without turning to me.
Say the complete sentence.
Yes, the criminal was the wife.
No reaction.
Sosei didn't even seem to be interested in the mystery game anymore. Exfoliation of Blood. Oh, I think that's the name of the movie he recommended. I changed my clothes and came back to the living room. Sosei was still watching the TV. Is this a video? What are you watching? I'm watching the self-produced film that you bought yesterday. Ah, the one I got from the filmmaking club? Is it good? Their performance is poor, but the lighting and directing are good. It's about a boy who struggles to lose his virginity and becoming a man. The title DDT is short for... is a short version of Datsudotei, losing a man's virginity in Japanese. Good job. It's not the name of a pesticide or wrestling. Okay. It's a typical subject. I can't say that I'm not related to it. Let's watch it later. No, please don't. Tsumugu, this is not a research film. Oh, about a film. I watched The Exfoliation of Blood. How was it? Oh my. Goyo is really genius. Exfoliation of Blood is a film about the feud between a father and a son who have good looks. Goyo was playing the role of the son. His father repeatedly assaults and murders women. The son tries to understand his father, feeling hatred towards his father at the same time. I'll skip the details in the middle of the story, but in the end, the son kills his father and peels his father's skin off. Like in typical psycho killer films, he became a psychopath and put his father's skin gown on. Wearing his father's skin, the son kills a woman, the son takes the skin gown off and finds a job and has a new family and becomes a real human. What? This is the end of the film. Oyo in that film was astonishing because he performed a psychopath and an ordinary person. It isn't that difficult to perform a psycho, however, it is difficult to act like a normal person because it's hard to adopt the features of an ordinary person. I think so too. Anyways, I had a doubt that the son really could have an ordinary life for the rest of his life in the end. Is the son, like, the son of Osoto from the previous game? That's possible criticism. The film itself depicted a universal and direct theme. I like that. The theme. What do you think the film wants to tell us? Rite of passage? You know, this is an initiation theme. The son killed his father to be superior. He replaced his father with his father's skin and took the skin off. And he had a new life. The theme has been used since ancient times. Oh. Wow, I didn't expect you to watch the film with deep thoughts on the story. I told you. I liked watching that film. Oh, I told you that I liked watching films. Sorry, I know. I just... underestimated you. How old was Koyo at that time? 18 years old. Oh my god. His performance is awesome at that young age. Is he a monster? I'll tell this to Koyo. Hey, just tell him you're a genius. The film of the filmmaking club ended. The credits ended in 3 seconds. There weren't many credits. Sosei used the remote of the DVD and then took the disc from the deck slowly. Oh, zombies. Let's ask about zombies. Do you know any films about the zombies in a house? Do you know any films about the zombies in a house estate in Japan? What's this all of a sudden? You switch subjects so often. Oh yeah? Aren't you aware of it? What's in your mind? Conversation is like catching a ball. I was wondering if... Listen. Listen to me.
there's a film like that? I searched for it on the internet, but couldn't find it. I found some, but it wasn't zombies in a housing estate I wanted. I don't know either. If there is, I must find it. It must be fun. That's a pity. Can anybody make it for me? No, you don't need that kind of content. That's it? Why are you so obsessed with zombies? You're a weird child. I don't know what to think of him. I still love him, damn it.